Welcome to Living the Empowered Life channel. My name is Yvonne and this channel is all about bringing you content that's empowering, encouraging and inspiring. Also on this channel I share with you things that I do to live an empowered life. Also I share book reviews of books that I've read in case you want to check them out for yourself. And also every now and then I share with you products that I've bought in case you want to check those out too. So if this is the type of content that you're looking for, please hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. And don't forget to hit the thumbs up if you like the video. So today really is a quick review of a planner that I bought last year in 2020. Somebody requested that I do a video, just a walkthrough of the planner and how I've used it. But I thought as well it would be a good chance just to update you on my thoughts on the planner, how I found using it the last year, and just some bits and pieces of information that you might be interested in case you are thinking about buying this planner. So I bought this planner, the Ella Iconic CEO of My Own Life planner, back in September 2020. So how I found this planner is that I was looking for a replacement planner for the ones that I used to buy. For the last 3 years preceding buying this planner, I always bought the Kate Spade planner. For me, those planners were just absolutely perfect. And that is why I bought them for 3 years in a row. But sadly, because Kate Spade passed away, I can't remember which year it was, whether it was 2018 or 2019. No sooner after that had happened, I started to notice that her stationery, including her planners, started to dwindle and you couldn't get the planners anywhere really. They released maybe one planner, and the planner design I didn't really like because I kind of like the more kind of classic luxury designs like Dalmatian spots and prints and things like that. So that is how I ended up finding out about this planner. So it's a little bit battered, as you would expect for having it for nearly a whole year. So I paid £41.40 for this planner over here in the UK, that's in Great British Pounds. I got a discount of 10% off because obviously I'm a new customer, so they were given a little incentive, so that was great. And I paid £3.99 shipping to get the planner sent to me, so in total it came to about £46 and some pence. So when I did get this planner, I was really impressed, and as a matter of fact I did my very first unboxing of a planner on this channel, which has hit over 1,000 views now, which is quite amazing because really I was just doing something that I'd never done before on my channel, just sharing an unboxing, and I will leave a link to the video at the top here somewhere. I was really impressed with the planner. I loved the way it was presented. It came in a beautiful presentation box, and when you opened it up it had lovely kind of tissue paper protecting the planner. It was very well packaged. It had a welcome card and a personalized little card to say thank you for buying the planner. And those first impressions for me was really amazing because I do like when I do spend money on something to have it really nicely presented and look like, you know, they really appreciate, you know, the customer that's bought it. And that definitely did come across with my first impressions of the planner. So I didn't really start using the planner until about April 2021. That is because over here in the UK we were still in the midst of the pandemic lockdown. A lot of my work, you know, where I'd go out and do contracts and have meetings and stuff, obviously a lot of that was cancelled. I did have some online work and stuff, but the way that I would use my planner to the capacity that I would use it had not been that much because obviously my work had halved. So I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough of my diary. Obviously I'm not going to go through lots of it because it's got a lot of my personal information and things in there, but I just want to give you kind of a taste of, you know, how I used each part of the planner. So obviously here we have the first page, which kind of just gives you an introduction to the planner. And then in this inside pocket or inside page, you have the pocket where you can put all your loose papers and stuff, which is really handy. So it's just got like a welcome page, just welcoming you to using the CEO of My Life planner. And then it has on this page how to use the planner. So it just gives you kind of an overview of what kind of things you should be putting in your planner, and then it's got a bit more detail on how to use it here as well. What I did like about the planner, it has little quotes and motivational stuff in it, This was on the first page. Let's begin. Your beautiful journey starts right here. Full wonderful days are ahead, which was quite nice. And basically, this is where you start. It asks you to put your word for the year, what you will and will not do, what you're most excited about. And it also has a space for you to put your thoughts and observations about the year. So we've just got here a calendar overview of 2021. I didn't really use that at all. Then it's got things like, the holidays for the year. Every beginning of the year, I do a Daniel fast. I don't mind showing you that. And I plan on doing it again next year. But it just gives you a breakdown on all the national holidays. Also here, you've got a space for important dates. So I didn't really put a lot in these kind of sections, but you can put like important birthdays and things in there. Contacts, I didn't use that at all just because I keep my contacts in my phone. On this page, it's about imagining your future, taking time to write down, or draw out the things that you want to achieve in the next 12 months. I made very good use of this page. Again, this is like my big master plan for the 12 months. What you could do is to write down your goals in that section and then write down your action steps or action plans here. You've got a progress tracker for the month, but then you have an overall year one, which kind of I felt, duplicated stuff. The one for the month is actually, much better and I think is more practical. You have a month at a glance and you have a year at a glance. Again, I didn't really use this section. I used more the month at a glance because that suited me better, but you can use the year one as well. Also, it gives you space here to kind of write notes about the year at a glance as well. I suppose you can use these pages as spare pages for notes if you don't want to do that. Then we've got time for adventure. I didn't go anywhere out of the country this year, so that remained blank. Again, I didn't write nothing on that page. I did manage to put some of the books that I have read this year, and as a matter of fact, I've read a lot more books than that, but I just didn't put it into my planner. So that's something I'm going to probably update at the end of the year. Has as well a place for you to kind of write down your plans, first quarter plans, all the different quarters of the year, type of things you want to achieve, business, career, family. So this is just a month at a glance. This was January 2021. I did use all the other months a bit more better because, as I said, it was a bit quiet at the beginning of the year. This is an example of how to use the habit tracker. So I had my different things that I wanted to keep track of my habits, and then each day I would cross off if I done them. I did really well that month actually. So this is for the week. Again, split up into four sections: business, career, home, family, health and fitness, and personal. And you just write in the boxes the things that you wanted to achieve. And this is just an example of my master to-do list for the week of 4th to the 10th of January 2021. So, throughout my diary, I did make very good use of these sections. So this is just a typical day in my planner, and that is how it is throughout. Basically, at the top of the planner here, you've got your mantra for the day. I've put there, keep positive. Then you've got like your day's top priorities and the four sections that I've told you about for business, career, home, family, and all those different things. And then you have space to put in the times of the stuff that you want to do. So that is how a typical layout of the day looked for me. At the bottom, as I mentioned, it has today I'm thankful for, and I've just put being motivated to do things. So as mentioned, the back page has completely come off. As mentioned, if I can be bothered to put it on later, I will do. But it's quite fiddly, a little bit annoying. And basically, on the back page, the one that I told you that came out, it's basically a 2021 review. I will somehow put it back in, even though like the stubs have been ripped. But basically, you can review the year's highlights and take stock of your year. So as you can see from those little clips that I've put in about my planner and how I used it and the little sections that I use, it's obviously quite an extensive planner. And I get the name totally why it's called CEO of My Own Life, because literally it covers an absolute lot. You probably couldn't tell from the video, but the planner is actually really quite thick as you can see, it is heavy as well. If you're carrying like a kind of handbag, you know, with the handles, and you put it in, you definitely feel the weight. If you have it on your shoulder, not as much. And you know, for predominantly quite a lot of the year, because still, you know, a lot of places weren't opening up, apart from going to meetings, really my planner I was just using in my office. Now I'll tell you what I really did like about my planner, and I've actually made some notes here because I really wanted to do a fair review about this planner and, you know, take my time to think about the things that really did work for me. So what I really liked was the spacious day pages. As you can see from the video, you had, you know, the layout for the day, and then you had like, you know, the different sections for like business, personal, home, family and stuff, where you could just put the little bullet points in of the things that were really important for the day. I really liked the part where it said, you know, what you are thankful for at the bottom of each page. I really did like that, you know, because that helps you kind of keep everything in perspective. I did really like at the beginning of every month, the month at a glance view. I thought that was really good. Sometimes when I forgot to put things in the day planner, what was going on for the day, the month at a glance planner, you could just put in the things that were really important on each day. So I really liked that. One of the things that I really loved as well was the habit tracker. The habit tracker was absolutely amazing. I never came across habit trackers before. I didn't have them in my Kate Spade planners, but in this planner I had the habit tracker, and that has helped me to kind of get on top of really good habits. And because of that, actually having that habit tracker in there, I did a whole video on the benefits of habit trackers. Again, I will leave a link to that at the end of this video. So there were some things that I didn't like about the planner, and I think it's important that I'm honest about that. I'm somebody that has used planners and things like that for nearly 20 years. And one of the things I found really difficult about using this planner is that it had too many boxes. And that might sound like a really bizarre thing to say, but I always felt a little bit with this planner, a little bit kind of micromanaged, and a little bit guilty sometimes when I didn't use every single space that was provided. Don't get me wrong, you know, I think it's a very comprehensive planner, but I just found for myself that it had too many boxes, and at times I just found it a little bit kind of overwhelming, a little bit like I was kind of micromanaging myself, which in the real world, you can't really do that because things happen from day to day. Even though the CEO planner is something to help you really manage your life and stuff like that, I did feel a little bit that it took the fun out of using a planner for me as well. Because, you know, when I get a planner, it's supposed to be fun, exciting. Surprisingly, what I did find with this planner, as thick as it was, as detailed as it was, with as many boxes as there were, is that there wasn't a lot of spare pages just for notes. You may have like one page for notes, but there wasn't like, you know, a good few pages where you could write lots of different notes. And I found myself having to go into a notebook or something else, say for instance when I was in a meeting or something, to write down those additional notes, because really there wasn't really anywhere else in there to do that. Obviously I could have gone into the page maybe for Thanksgiving, or the page designated for writing how many books you read in a year or something like that. I just found it a little bit kind of surprising that there wasn't any spare pages or pages for notes in this planner. And the other thing that I didn't like about this planner that I actually wrote to their customer service about was this, where the back page has completely come off. I'm not sure if it's to do with the coiling. I don't know if you can see that on the planner, with this gap, and for it being so thick as well, if that is part of the problem why the back page kept coming off. And you know, page came out and stuff, and that could just be from wear and tear anyway. But I did not like the fact that this back page came off the planner. And I think that, you know, for how much I paid for it, I wasn't expecting that. I'm somebody who has bought expensive planners for a very long time, right back from back in the day, going back to 2006, 2007, the Filofaxes. I had Filofaxes in every colour. They were very expensive planners. I've had other planners during the course of my time over the years, Kate Spade planners, all different types of planners, and I've never had any problems with them. They've always been very well made and, you know, worth the money. But I just felt, you know, this really did kind of put a dampener on things for me, because, you know, I expected something that would have been well made. I think probably by September, October this year, I kind of wasn't really using it that much anyway, for the reasons that I've said, and obviously because the back page kept coming off. And I had to keep putting back on the back page, which was really, really annoying. And, you know, I did take the time out, as I said, to write to their customer services to tell them, you know, and give them feedback about this. I haven't heard anything back from them. But if you are considering buying this type of planner, that's just something to be mindful of. I'm not telling you not to buy it. I'm just sharing with you my experience of buying this planner. I don't know if I will be buying this planner again. I've actually got a new planner for 2022, which is more kind of in line with the things that I've been used to before, a bit more to my suiting. It hasn't got any coiling or anything like that. It's like a really kind of nice hardback planner with a black and white Dalmatian design with gold gilding, you know, on the pages, around the page edges, and it's personalized. And I will be doing a video on that as well. And I would love to hear from you, you know, your experience of using this planner. What are the things you loved about it? Did you have any problems with it? Will you be buying the 2022 version of the CEO of My Life planner? I would love to hear from you. But that was just my little review video, and I will see you on the next one. Take care.